Hey, what's up, guys? It's me, Edison. This is your usual setup. Me at the table. I'm about to go for a bike ride, but I got some packages in, so I want to do a quick unboxing. You'll see right here. So I got some Blue Eyes White Dragons. I went to a Target by me, and I saw like they had these. What are they called? The Egyptian Old God decks that just came out, and I think those decks are really unplayable and bad, but it got me thinking, like, wow, Yu-Gi-Oh cards are probably, there's a lot of, like, cards that are significant or, like, have nostalgia for me that I could probably find, like, reprints of for cheap. And this was the case with this. I found these. I just bought them on TCG Player. They're, like, $2 a piece. I bought 20 of them. I'm just going to sleeve them and do binder pages. You know, these aren't significant anyway. Modern, 2020, first edition. I don't think any of this matters for Yu-Gi-Oh. I think even for this stuff, unlimited might be even rarer. Because, you know, I think it's like print to demand, and if the demand's not there, they might not come out with much unlimited. But that stuff's that. And the rest of the stuff's a lot cooler. The title of this video is probably gonna be, you know, the rarest gold star, which that is in this video. There is a version of gold stars. If you know Japanese cards, and I mentioned it in a different video of mine, there's a very rare iteration of Pokemon, Japanese Pokemon, which I believe it's in here. Let me open this up. And it's not a promo or anything. It is a set card. I want to pull up the pop reports. I'm going to have them. We're going to compare the pop for like the play gold stars, the play promo gold stars, because that's like the one that most people think of when they think of rare cards. They think of the play promos. This is a little bit more stuff than I remember. I think this guy just gave extra cards. We'll do this first. They're all the same thing. I guess he just sandwiched it between other cards. What free cards did I get? Oh, nice. I got some free energy cards. That's just garbage. Oh, here it is. Back is a little beat. Pretty rough. Maybe a low grade. Maybe a 5? This could be a little bit higher, maybe like a 6. But it is a Flareon Gold Star. Really nice. The world, this is from World's Champions pack in Japanese. It's just cool because the background of the card has a holo foil, and then there's a full body holo foil if I like tilt it like that. And if you see so obviously there's a play promo which has the P there for play. Then there's the World Champions pack. I spoke about this in the past, but for this stuff, for the World Champions pack, I think it was like 2007 or 6, when they had the World Championship. The English like card release was actually a set ahead of Japanese. So to introduce a lot of these cards that were in that set, I think it was EX Emerald. Might not have been EX Emerald, might have been EX Deoxys. But to introduce those cards into Japanese, they printed the World Champions pack, which was, I think you could pre-order in person, but there was also an online version. It wasn't very popular. And so the first print that they did, which has the first edition stamp in this corner, that's the one you see more often, but it wasn't very popular. So when they did the unlimited print later on, I think they ended up closing that print run early because it just wasn't fulfilled enough. And along with that, I think it was just a scarcer thing because they were supposed to be given out for purchase at I think 5 events, and 3 of those events that year got canceled. So the unlimited is much, much rarer. I don't have the population numbers up right now, but to my knowledge, it's for all of the evolutions. I shouldn't say all. You don't have Umbreon and Espeon gold stars in this set, but you have Flareon, Jolteon, Vaporeon. On PSA, you know, this might be outdated, but they're all single pop. Like single digit pop, I think none go over 10. I'm very confident. I'm fairly confident about that. I think Jolteon was like a 7. That was a lot of talking, but I really like this card. And as I mentioned, these were more of them. So I just like randomly was going through, I refresh Mercari Japan quite often. Like, because at this point, essentially, it's like, you know, my job to find these deals. And I saw the Flareon pop up. I think it was maybe this one. I saw that pop up and I was so excited because I haven't seen an unlimited gold star in a while. I picked that one up, and then very soon after, another Flareon got listed. And then I just searched other sites. Just free cards. I think they were just in that packaging to preserve it. And then this one I think was on Yahoo Japan for a while. This one was pretty cheap. This one was like $200. I think $200 for a very low population card. And, you know, Eeveelution for $200 in general is a gold star. I think is a great price. Just great. Like, these artworks are good. I would probably say Flareon's my favorite of the gold stars. And here's the last one. Just another Flareon gold star World Champions pack. So if you see this logo on Japanese card, just know that it's from the World Champions pack. And obviously look if there's a first edition stamp or not. This one is in significantly better condition. Actually, I'll be right back. Let me show you some other stuff. Let me grab some. So I got these in the mail a couple of days ago, and because there's only two cards, I didn't make a video. But here's another Vaporeon Unlimited World Champions pack that I have. And in that same package, I ended up picking up a Shadowless Charizard. It's very beat up. I'm going to estimate it to 4. I'm sending this into CGC. So, I mean, like, with everything I do, I send it into CGC. But yeah, I just wanted to show I have 2 Flareons, 2 Vaporeons, and hopefully I can pick up at least 2 Jolteons.
So I'm not sure where I'm going to interject this into the video, but I did actually want to look at the PSA population reports. And while this isn't like the most accurate, because some stuff is probably in PSA backlog, you know, if it's standard order or bulk order, and there is probably stuff at BG that's been graded by BGS, but the BGS pop reports like almost impossible to use. So for like for the most part, I think using the PSA pop report to judge how much is out there for this type of stuff is fairly accurate. Not the most accurate, but I think it still does make a pretty good point. So I mentioned that the ones that go for, you know, a lot of money and you always see pop up on PWCC auctions or just on eBay in general are the play promos. So let's start with the first card we saw, which was the Flareon play promo, Flareon Gold Star. We can see here in PSA, PSA is graded 67 total, 1-4, which I think this is was one that my friend graded, but 21 nines and 36 tens. So yeah, pretty good, 57 graded 9 or above. If we look at the World Champions pack, which you know these cards are from, they've graded a total of 65 for the first edition, 43 tens, 12 nines. But if we check for gold stars of unlimited, they've graded a total of 6. So between, like, just look at this. The play promo version has more copies graded than the World Champions pack first edition, by just a very small margin. But it's 10 times rarer, or by this metric, 10 times rarer in the unlimited variant. So there's 65 total graded versus 6. And this holds true for the other versions as well. I showed off a Vaporeon in this video. 156 Vaporeon gold stars graded, 103 and 10, 36 and 9. If we go over to the pop report for World Champions pack, that's right here, we see 50 Vaporeons have been graded in first edition, 20 tens, 22 nines. But for unlimited, a total of 8 have been graded, with most being around 9. So this is just cool to see, and this kind of helps illustrate my point really well. I just wanted to show that this really is like the definitive rarest iteration of these cards.
But I think Jolteon, I don't know if it was just rarer. I assume the pull rate were the same, but I haven't seen many Jolteons pop up, and they tend to seem to go for a little bit more than the other two. I don't know if it's because it's a more popular Pokemon, because I really thought the Eeveelutions were. I thought Vaporeon might have been the favorite. Yeah, Jolteon's probably actually up there. And then the last stuff, this is just some mix of Japanese bulk cards that I got in. So the main part was to show off these gold stars and just talk about the rarity of them all. And the other part is to go over this old back stuff. All this stuff was supposed to have been mint, but we'll go through it. I paid around like $10 in old back hollow. So just, I thought $10 was really fair to pick up these. And you know, if they're gradable, they do pretty well. And if not, you know, this type of stuff sells pretty consistently. You know, for $15, $20 on eBay. You know, you might have to sit on it for a while, but definitely get your money out. This one was a little bit more. I paid like $150 for a Stormfront Charizard, but it looked really mint. I mean, this one looks great. This is probably getting graded. Nice Charizard. Let's set that aside because it's actually high value. 7-Eleven Absol promo ADV. It's a little beat up. This one's a little sad. It's a little beat up. And then EX. I really like my EX cards, and I pretty much grade every EX that I buy. And Meganium. This one was just nice. It's a nice holo. Pretty good condition as well. And then, as I said, just, you know, some more old back, and then a dark Houndour. No, Houndoom. Houndoom is this the ball form. All right, quick video. Really just wanted to show the World Champions pack cards, talk about them for a bit, and go over briefly some mail that I had. All right. Have a nice one, guys.